Close my eyes, passion of what I do. I don't have to really retire. I'll definitely take days off so we can chill together. But I'm going to enjoy giving because you have given me, if you had $1 in your pocket, that dollar belonged to me. And so I'm looking forward to being able to give back to you. You have taught me how to give. That wasn't my natural, your spiritual gift is giving. That's not mine. But I'm learning to give more. And I want the sky to be the limit because that's what you did for me. The sky was always the limit when it came to Arnell providing for us and giving us, no matter what. He has spoiled me rotten. And many of you know that. There's nothing that he won't do for me. And so he has spoiled his daughter rotten, and we both are in the same position that he knows, we know that whatever we put our hands out for, if he can afford to do it, he will. And so we just want you to know how much we love you and how much we appreciate you. And I try to invite people from different walks of your life. You're retired from the post office. You haven't retired as a musician yet, but you retired from being employed as a musician. So we have people represented from Brooklyn Tabernacle, when you played there, Agape, when you played there, and then the post office from New York and the postal service here in New Jersey. And you have your sister who has come to celebrate with you, and then those who are in the pastor, you didn't retire from being a pastor, so we just started. But we have the pastors here. And so we just want you to have fun tonight and enjoy yourself.
So I do not have any notes. I did not write anything down. So I'm going to write from the heart. But 31 years is a long time because I'm only 32. So it's my whole life. So, to me, what that signifies is that you realized when you got my mother pregnant,
it was man up time.
And we were married.
And you were married, but it was still man up time. You needed that job, that good, you know, pension, and you did what you had to do. And for 31 long years, you stayed on that job, whether you liked it or not. And I know that you did that specifically for us. And so one thing that I can say is that you were consistent. I never once even had to imagine you not being in our home. It was never a thought that crossed our minds. It was never a thought that crossed my mind. I never thought that I would wake up one day and you weren't going to be there, or that I would come home from school and you weren't going to be there. And even in the times when it got rough, and even that one time you did pack your bags. I know you look back at your children and said, no, I can't do it. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart for being that rock, for being that consistent figure. And I know for sure that I am the man that I am because of you. And I know that my family is going to thrive because of your example. You didn't have to say much. You didn't have to preach it to us. You just were. You were it. And it's amazing for me to look back now after all these years and to see you where you are, the man of God that you are. And your strength is amazing. And I love you and I thank you for it. Everything done for us, and I'll tell some few funny stories. Okay, I'm not gonna take this story, but there's a funny story. So there was this one time where I was not being a good boy, and I was in the room with my cousins. You know where I'm going with this. And I thought I was really cool, you know, because I was like, I don't know, maybe 12. And I was doing something we weren't supposed to do. That was cussing. And I was cussing up a storm. I was telling a story to my cousin. And I was cussing up a storm. And next thing I know, everybody in the room got real quiet. And everybody was looking at me like, stop. Just don't say another word. And I was like,
you're real bad.
And next thing I know, I turn around and there was this silhouette. This figure seemed really big. My dad is not that big. But this figure at this moment seemed huge to me. It was ominous, like something was gonna get me. And he was like standing there, and he was like, and that was it. I knew it was over at that point, but I said that to say my dad is not a man of many words, but his actions were grand. He pulled my butt. When I say butt, I don't say any other curses to you. Cursing is not an option. Thank you for your hand of correction. I'm going to pass it on. I love you and thank you.
But I was thinking about this time where I was a freshman in college and I was sitting at the table with all my friends and I was talking about how my dad wanted to retire. And I was talking about it from such a selfish perspective that I didn't know at the moment. And so I was like, I really don't want him to retire because like, I'm going to pay my college tuition. And all my friends were like, Deborah. And I was like, that's selfish? They're like, yeah, that's really selfish. You know, like parents, not all parents pay for college tuition. And now that I'm thinking about it, I know that I was just, like my father never made me feel like he was breaking his back to do the things that he was doing for us and making sure that I never stepped foot in a post office. That's what he said. I don't ever step foot in a post office. And I don't have to do that because he worked so hard to make sure that I had everything that I needed. And I really don't know if my dad's ever said no for anything. It might be maybe later or, you know, maybe a couple months or something, but whatever he had to do, he was doing it to make sure that his kids had more than he had growing up. And that's such a blessing because not all parents are really focused on that. Even, you know, some friends that I have now, when they say they need things, I'm like, that's your parents. Like, I mean, it's not really like that. And I'm blessed that I have you, that I can come to you for anything. And I know that you will come through. Not just, you know, financial needs, but anything. And I have always been the most spoiled one. And there was a time last year. He's laughing because he tells this. He has to tell everybody this. Anybody that steps foot in the house, he got to tell this story, right? About how I crashed his brand new Cadillac. Yeah, that happened. So I crashed his brand new Cadillac, and when I called him to tell him I just got a car accident, I was crying. It was my first car accident. He was rushing. He's like, "Oh, come, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it." When I told Kevin the story, when I told Kevin something, he was like, what? He didn't yell at you? He didn't scream at you? Kevin told the story about how he just nicked the car.
It was a Toyota Echo.
That I'm very grateful for, and I just want to say that I love you. And another thing is, I didn't voice this, and I haven't voiced it yet, but I'm very excited. So I've been in school, I haven't really lived in the house for like 3 years, only in summers. But I'm really excited to be able to live in the house with you again, and you not have to be busy with work, because you know you really didn't like that job. And it kind of showed, you know, I wasn't really the happiest all the time, but now I know that you're a lot more relaxed and freed up in time. I'll be excited to be able to spend more time with you, go places, and not have to worry about you getting tired from work, stuff like that. So I love you a lot.
all those things. I'm coming from the left. Me and my dad got a nice relationship, nice joking relationship. Obviously, y'all all know him to be a character. And just to piggyback on top of Kiera's Cadillac story, yeah, he was like, you know, I'm just glad you're okay and all these things. And he got home, and when he got to me, he like, so crash my Cadillac! Nah, but anyway, no, I got a few stories because I know a lot of people in here, y'all know Pastor Arnell as Pastor Arnell. Y'all don't know the one that raised me, the earlier one. Because when he was younger, in his more, you know, in his days where he would be willing to do something else. What about that time when you did you cut the sleeve off your boss? Pastor Arnell, he cut the sleeves off his boss's jacket one day when he was angry. It was in the dead of winter. Got kids. Gotta keep a job and cut the sleeves off his boss's jacket. I'm gonna keep going. One day, came home, he used to tell me stories that like maybe he wouldn't tell my mom right away. You know, he just talked about it. One day, he was out in the streets, not the streets, he's working, out in the streets with his mail truck. And he had to get to a mailbox. And you know, in New York, there's a lot of homeless people. One day, this lady decided to, this lady was sleeping on the mailbox and decided to hit my dad with the pillow that she was sleeping on. She said the pillow was pretty dirty. Tried to take the pillow from her. The lady didn't want to give up the pillow. So they ended up in the street. Imagine when she was in the streets in New York slinging a homeless person around the circus because he was upset. It's your pastor talking about. He slung the homeless lady in three circles in the street because he upset. You heard it, right? What did he say? That's true. That's true. Just making sure y'all know. No, he's different now, but this was the old one, the stories I got. So now my final story that I got is not, it has nothing to do with mail, but just to show you how wild my dad is, but he, listen, he probably don't even want me to tell. One day, we home alone. Traumatizing, but he apologized, doesn't matter. One day, we home alone. He's taking a shower, right? This is crazy. He's taking a shower. He makes a bunch of noise in the shower. Like, to where it sounds like it's an emergency. I'm about 7. I come in, he's passed out in the shower, pretending like he done hurt himself. And I'm 7. Now I'm like, now I'm kneeling over him like, Dad, wake up! He's like, who does that? Now I gotta think, like, if you really pass out, I gotta pump you. Like, you really passed out. So yeah, those are some of the stories that I have. So now to get back to it. I also learned a lot of things from watching my father grow up. Obviously, if y'all know me, one thing that I can do and that I learned how to do for my father is to get through it. So, you know what I'm saying? I've learned how to be a man, put your hand to the plow, and go to work day in, day out. Y'all know I'm not the type to call out. I like to get to work and do what I gotta do. I have a former supervisor in the building. He just didn't get an eye right now. That was when I was about 19. I used to work for Trail at the hospital. He's telling a different story right now with his eye. But no, I go to work. But anyway, I learned that from my dad. I learned that from my dad coming up. And he, again, just like my siblings have said, he always, you know what I'm saying, whether he had to go to work for 18 hours in a row to go get us something that he wanted to get us. He wouldn't show us the 18 hours that he had to work. He'd just come home with what it was that we needed. I remember when I was younger and I was playing my little groove percussion drum set. It was $200. I was playing that drum set until I was about 17. And it was time for a new one. I was like, hey, you think I can just get a new drum set? He's like, a new drum set? What you get a new drum set? What is good? I was like, it's just not anymore. He's like, it looks good to me. I'm like, all right, but I really, if we could. And it wasn't even a week later. I mean, he bought me one of the best drum sets there was out there. I still have it to this day. I travel with it. It's my best set. So yeah, no, before I start crying, I'll just thank you for all that you've done for me.
Tonight. him, and he is has the most genuine heart. So what you see is what you get. So although you're retired from the post office, your new job is now really beginning, right? Right, so there's a greater expectation in ministry now, right? Right, so ain't no retirement from the piano yet, right? Right, okay, so, you know, welcome to your new job. Absolutely, but we are honored to be a part of your ministry and what God is doing through you for us and the body of Christ. We love you.
We love you.
Okay, the mic is still open. Well, come on. Somebody wants to say nice things on the song.
That's all.
What's that?
I'm about to start
picking. So if you guys want to come up, just come on up here and you know, get in line.
So my name is Marlo Cooper, and I'm here with my husband Dennis. So, like Tracy, I met Don Arnell at Cooper Tabernacle Deliverance Center, and he was our organist and our minister of music. And what you see is exactly what someone said is what you get. And Arnell was the most dedicated person, committed person. When we were raggedy, when we sound good, when we didn't sound good, he let us know, but he was there with us faithfully. Arnell would literally run from work in his post office uniform with that hat. That picture is from our church. That's on the program. And he would sit there at the organ with his little furry hat and his postal uniform, and we had choir rehearsal. So Arnell, you meant a lot to us, as you know, and we had so many good times. And Arnell was also my musician at our wedding. And we just really love Arnell. And just to see him as a pastor, to see how God has blessed you, is just wonderful. So I just really had to get up and tell you, as you know, we love you. We love your wife, Danita. I talked to your sons. Kevin goes, I think I'm supposed to know you because your face looks familiar. And Arnell would bring the boys, and they would sit on the little bench with him while he, on the seat while he was playing the organ. So we love your family. We, like I said, this is over 30 years. And so we truly love you. I was honored to get an invite. And like Tracy, when I saw the invite from your wife, Danita, I was like, oh, you're coming. You definitely have to come and make our way here. So I just want to tell you I love you. And happy retirement.
She's a pastor, so it's probably a little bit challenging to do 1 minute, 30 seconds. But my Aunt Jeanette is representing my mom. If any of you know my mom, she looks just like her, and her actions are just like her. And so we just want you to come and share. I'm gonna stand next to you and help you with the 1 minute.
Thank you.
So we want at least one minister, someone to represent the cloth. Please come forward. Now you are that long-winded minister. We're gonna ask you to pass the mic to somebody else. PD Ray. Wait, PD.
Thank God for this new journey and ministry and grandkids. And it's exciting. And we're just leaving God with you for the best. The best is yet to come. And we've been talking about pastoring for a long time. And we just thank God for you and obeying that call.
Amen. Peter, you did good. You did all right. I was nervous.
Well, I just want to thank everybody. It was I was totally caught off. It's hard to catch me because my nose is really in everything. I don't know how to cut. I was my son's house the other day. My sister had gotten in there, so I was wondering why he was trying to edge me out of the house. They were trying to get me out. They had the saints telling stories. Satan rebuked me. But they were telling a little other things. So they were actually fixing up whatever they were doing at his house, and I thought it was somebody else. And it was for me. And so I'm grateful for the time that I was spent here and with all of you. I'm glad to be out of the post office because I was probably this close to becoming many of prison. But I would have had to deal with Big Bubba. So I'm glad that I got out when I did. I went out in style. We're not going to talk about that. But I'll tell you what happened. Anyway. So I had this supervisor that I had to pray for. And she was giving me a hard time. I mean, my integrity was tested. And I got 50%, it's 50-50. So you take the side you want. But anyway, it just happened to be October 30th when I retired. And of course, October 31st, I think it's Halloween. And so my next door neighbor happened to be a makeup artist. And I said, okay. Okay. So I snapped the picture of my supervisor and gave it to the makeup artist. And I said, now it's Halloween. I said, can you make me makeup? So, she looked at it, she said, yeah, I can do that, that's no problem. So, night, I had to go in at 10 o'clock. So, she started working on me about 9 o'clock. And I went out, bought this long wig, because she was about this tall, about this in the front, and straight in the back. So, I got some stuff, and I put on this big thing on the front. I got a box. Stuffed it down in the back. I called one of my partners at the job and said, what does she have on? So I went out shopping. I got everything that she had on, light sneakers. So I had on the same exact thing that she had on. And I had on a blonde wig and I was painted Caucasian. And so when I went to work, I came in and I said, so good that I was actually sitting in a chair. You know, we had to come in and report and get our assignments of where we're going. So I got an opportunity to sit in her chair. And the other employee coming, Miss Jones, where
fucked up. So, I did that. Yeah, I went out in a little fashion. Of course, she tried to get everybody to get me put out. The top manager said, well, what do you want me to do? So, I went out in a little fashion. I asked God to, no, I'm sorry. I understand, son. And God is still good. I'm still saved. Amen.
Amen.
So I had one out of the style way. I had some people that never even spoke to me and came to the best thing I have ever seen. Since I've been in the post office, I've never seen nothing like it. So we had a ball, and so that was my exit. But I'm glad to be out, I'm glad to begin to work in the ministry on a more full-time basis.
Amen.
And I'm glad. It's all in the past now. I remember all the good times I had. And just the other day, this young man here, stand up there. We go back a long ways. I remember he came in, he was just a little young buck. We used to tease him because he couldn't get the routes that he wanted. And he is from my former station in New York. It must have been about at least 20 years ago when I happened to run into him and right there in Riverport, bro, because he's moved out this way. And we hadn't seen each other in at least, what, 20 years?
Wow.
And I was surprised to see him today. I'm glad and grateful.
I know
that. That's how you got his number. Because I cracked my phone and lost all my contacts. And she had his wife, his number, I guess. I was glad to see him because we've been through thick and thin, right, Darryl?
That's right.
I can't tell those stories. I'm good on that. But I'm grateful. I'm just grateful to have all of you come out and support me on today. Just humbled by it. Glad to be here. Glad that you came. Amen.
And I just want to take a moment to thank each of you for coming, but I want to thank our event planners. I don't know why my daughter-in-law is over there boo loving. I'm trying to thank her. Her husband has surgery and he feels ill, so she feels like she needs to. That's what make him feel better right now. But thank you, Nikita. Thank you, Nikita. Thank you, Toya. Thank you, Tawana. They put all of this together and did the table settings and decorated the table in the back and made sure that everything went as planned. We really appreciate you. I appreciate you, Nate, our new son, for being our photographer on tonight. Thank you, man, John Vital Jr., for being our videographer. That's how you say it? Videographer. I do have a PhD. I got some education. Thank you. You called yourself a couple of things, so a couple of things.
Tommy.
Thank you so much. You were the DJ for
his business.
Your business. Your company. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Did I forget anyone? I don't think so. And thank you so much to our comedian. You did a wonderful job. And I know that Arnell loves to laugh. And so I knew that we needed to get a comedian here tonight. And so thank you so much. Thank you, Robin. As soon as we let you know, you got your plane ticket and you came on out to support your brother. We appreciate you. And that's it. We have 30 minutes to have some fun. What have you been having fun with? Y'all ready? Bodily exercise does some, okay? So we're gonna exercise our body.